out and talking to Oswalt. Don't know what's wrong with him.
He's going to be forced to leave this game. I don't know if he has blisters or whatever, but this is not good.
Zeal swings and misses, and that'll do it in the second inning.
I mean, if you look at, we got a base hit.
Now we got a line drive. The left coming on is Berkman, and he makes a nice play for the second out of the inning.
Great. We just got over Lance Berkman. He's a solid player.
He's actually played some center field for the Astros, so he does have the range, and you can see that he has the good hands and holds on as he tumbles.
You got four or five guys that they're going to use out in the pen.
Jeter goes down on strikes. Nasty pitch there by Kirk Sorolos. 1-2. He struck him out on a breaking ball, and an impressive 1-2-3 inning for Brad Lidge. And the 2-2. Well, he just tied a major league record. He struck out four Yankees in the inning. An outstanding performance by Dotel. The 1-2. He struck him out. Eight strikeouts in a row for Houston pitchers. And the Astros are one out away from no hitting the Yankees.
You know, I think Yankee fans appreciate good baseball, but I think they're cheering to break this thing up.
And the pitch. Grounded right side. They're going to do it. It's fielded by Bagwell. Flips to Wagner. And the Astros have the strangest no-hitter you'll ever see. Six pitchers combined to shut down the Yankees. Hold them down without a hit. And the Yankees are no-hit for the first time since 1958. The longest streak in baseball history without a no-hitter has been broken. And it's done by six men. Oswalt, Monroe, Sorolos, Lidge, Dotel, and Billy Wagner finished it off. A very strange evening in the Bronx. Baseball history is made, and it's history the Yankees really didn't want to be a part of.